Good morning, students. Today, in this lecture, we will discuss about the satellite communication. In our previous lectures, we have seen why we are using the optical fiber communication. So, first of all, we will discuss about the why we are opting the optical fiber communication and what is the comparison between optical fiber communication and satellite communication. So, first of all, we have seen that if we are opting the optical fiber communication, so that is the basically wire line communication, means there is a fiber connected between transmitter and receiver sections. But when we are opting the satellite communication, we will promote the mobility. If we are moving in a vehicles, so at that particular place, wire line connection is not possible. So, optical fiber communications and satellite communication, both are giving us the large bandwidth. So, that is a basic requirement of our, if we are require the large bandwidth and if we also want the mobility. With respect to large bandwidth, if there is also a requirement of mobility, then at that conditions, we have to opt the satellite communications. And if we are talk about the reliability, so with respect to optical communications, reliability in satellite communication is less, but after that it is a reliable for our information transmission. So this is the basic reason ki when we compare our optical fiber and satellite, so there are two factors. Both are giving the large bandwidth. In spite of optical fiber are given us the so many amount of large bandwidth requirement, they fulfill our bandwidth requirement multiple times of the bandwidth of the satellite communication, but it is not possible to mobility in our optical fiber communication. So there is a great limitations of our optical fiber system. So for opting the mobility, if there is a requirement of mobility, so we have to opt the satellite communication. So now we will see what about the satellite communication. So first of all, we will see what is the satellite. So satellite is an object in a orbit that is called as a satellite, and a satellite can be either natural as moon. We can say moon is the satellite of our earth, or that can be human made satellite that can travel around the planet or around the our earth. So that is basically satellite is a object that is moving around our earth. Now we again, there is a certain graphs. So this is the earth and this is the satellite. So the satellite can be either man-made or it can be either natural. If you are talking about the geostationary satellite, so that is the 36,000 kilometer from our earth surface. So that is a, so in further, we will see the types of orbits, and according to that we will discuss. But in natural process, if we are talking about the satellite, so in general condition, we will assume that the height of satellite is 36,000 kilometer from our earth surface. So this is a satellite system. This is a very basic diagram of our satellite system. So we will see how we will transmit our signal. So first condition is we have to two earth stations. Okay, so in satellite communication system, we have two earth station, first earth station and second. So that is work just like a transmitter and receiver. And if we are talking about the satellite, which is the 36,000 kilometer from our earth surface, so that is work as a repeater or reflector. So we can't call it as a reflector because our waves are not only reflect from the surface of satellite, but there is a certain processes, certain phenomena will happens in our waves, and then it will be returned back to the earth. So first of all, if we are using the first earth station, that is working as a transmitter, and it will use a frequency for transmitting the signals in high power. So that is called as a uplink frequency. But when we return back, our signals are returned back from satellite, that frequency may be different. So this is also a reason ki we have to use the two different frequencies for uplink and downlink. Because if we are using the same frequency, there may be interference and our signals messages may be destroyed. So that up when our frequency will be reaches to the satellite, there may be certain processing will happens, and we have to reduce our satellite by applying the transponder, and then after low frequency, in low frequency we can send our signals to the again to the second earth station. So that is work as a receiver part. So now again we will see our basic part. So what is the basic advantage of our, if we are talking about the satellite, as we have to see, just you can see in this diagram again, the coverage area. If you are talking about the coverage area, if you want to cover your large area for broadcasting system or any type of transmission system, you have to opt the satellite, because satellite will cover the large coverage area. And if we are talking, there are 2000 more than 2000 communication satellites are working in our earth orbit, and that may be both private and government organizations. So that is a large number of satellites are still working. So we have also talking about the coverage area of satellite. So this is our coverage area. How you can see here, if you want to cover the whole earth, so whole earth can be covered by using the 3 satellites. So this is the ranges which is covered by the one single satellite. So you can assume how much coverage area is covered by a single satellite. So this is a 1/3 part of earth can be covered by a one geostationary satellite. So this is basic the diagram of our 3 geo satellites which can cover the whole earth, and we can transmit our signals from the complete whole earth by using the different satellites. If you are using the 3 satellites, you can cover complete earth for transmitting your masses of signals. Now we will to see why we have to require, why, what is the need of satellite communication. So there are 2 reasons. Initial level, we are opting the 2 methods of propagation. So initially we are using the ground wave propagation, still we are using the ground wave propagation, but there is a certain limitations of our ground wave propagations. Why? Because ground wave propagation is only suitable up to the 30 megahertz signals, and after that we cannot transmit our signals. So this is a one method of ground wave. If we are talking about the sky wave propagation, up to 40 megahertz signals can be transmitted by sky wave propagations, and it makes the use of the ionosphere. So there are different layers of in our atmosphere, troposphere, ionosphere layer, and by using these properties of these different layer, we are opting the different types of wave propagation in our communication system. So first one is ground wave, second one is sky wave. So later further, let's we see that little bit extra description of that ground wave propagation. That is a type of basically radio wave propagation, and it is generally work out in the surface area of our earth. These waves propagate over the earth surface, but low and medium frequency. Okay, so this is the basically at low frequency signals are transmitted through the surface of our earth, and this is mainly used for transmission between earth and ionosphere. So at the ionosphere means up to the ionosphere. So from earth to ionosphere layer, you can work in the ground wave propagation systems, and these are made by the different constituent of waves. Again, you can see here, this is a transmitter and this is a receiver, and you can transmit your signals only this parallel to the your curvature of earth. So these type of signals frequency will be very low or medium frequency wave signals can be propagated to the ground wave. So initially we know that basically what type of communication, amplitude modulation is basically performed by using the ground wave communication. So at initially you can see in your transistor or radio what type of bands we have to choosing, that is basically AM, medium wave, short wave. So that is a basically for amplitude modulation system. Generally medium wave transmission will be possible through the ground wave propagation. Now we will switch to the sky wave. So basically we will see what is the application. So radio communication coverage, as I have told you initially, presently we are working on the FM frequency modulation system, but initially we are working on the radio. Today we are also working on the amplitude modulation system in some areas also. So ground wave propagation we only use for one way communication. So military are also used for submarine as they penetrate into the significant depth of our sea water. So sometimes we are also using ground wave communication, AM, FM, television broadcasting, can be done with the help of ground waves. So all these type of communication is included in our ground wave propagation. So ground wave propagation of radio signal is ideally for short distance propagation on this frequency during the daytime. So the by using the ground wave propagations, only short distance communication can be possible. Now we will switch to the sky wave propagation. So what about the sky wave propagation? So in radio communication, sky wave, what we have to zone, it is work on the ionospheric level. Okay, and ionospheric layer is also made of different layers are included in our ionospheric layer, and that is basically electrically charged particles. Okay, so medium and short wave frequencies can be reflected back to the earth. So if you are transmitting your frequency higher than up to 2 megahertz or 10 megahertz higher than frequencies, and we transmit this frequency to the ionospheric layer, it will be reflected from the that particular layer. Actually, it will not reflect it. It will slightly bend it, and it will total internal reflections. It will also happens here. It will slightly bend it, and it will be returned back to the. So that is the bending mechanism of our microwave signal, and that is due to refraction. Okay. So in sky wave propagation, there is basically a refraction, and due to refraction, these waves are. After bending, it will return back to our earth surface. So this type of communication, we called it as a sky wave propagation. So just you can see here, these are the waves, these are the return back to the earth. But what will happen? You are seen here, this is the ionosphere. The lower part of layer is the tropospheric layer. And after then, what about after then? So we will discuss here, up to 40 megahertz. Up to 40 megahertz frequency can be returned back to the earth. But what about above frequency? If you are using the higher frequency, so that frequency will not return back to the earth. That frequency will be escaped to the atmosphere. So that is not possible if frequency has not returned back to the earth. So we cannot receive our signals or messages what we are transmitting through these high frequency signals. So this is the reasons for opting the higher frequency, because our requirement of bandwidth is increasing day by day. And why our bandwidth requirement is increasing? Because we have to require high speed data transmission. So for increasing our speed of communication, we have to require the large amount of bandwidth. And if we are stick to the 40 megahertz signals cannot be transmitted, so it is a very tough task for us, because these two types of mode of communication is basically wireless communication. So you have to opt again for the optical fiber communication. So what happens? You have to increase your mobility. So there is also the requirement of mobility plus large amount of bandwidth. So these two requirements can be fulfilled by the satellite communication, because by using the satellite communication, you can enhance your bandwidth requirement. So this is the reason for where we will block, and now we have to switch to the satellite. So this is the basically need of satellite communication. So the applications of this is satellite communication basically take place with the help of sky wave. So this is the basic reason sky wave. And what will happen satellite communication, mobile communication. Okay, so by if you want to communicate, mobile communication is also possible with help of your satellite communication. Because in our previous lecture, in mobile communication lectures, we have seen the basic architecture of our GSM and our cellular concept of mobile communication. So apart from these GSM architecture and cellular concept of our mobile communication, we also dependent on our satellite for communication, mobile communication. So in further slides we will see how we will depend on the mobile communications for satellite. So this is a basically ground wave. We have to see that you are escaped. Initially, you can go through the ground wave communication for lower frequency. After then, up to the 40 megahertz, you can go to the sky wave propagation. And after that, higher frequencies, you can switch to the satellite communication. So this is the conclusion ki why we are moving towards the satellite. And it is very important for us to opt the satellite communication for our fulfill the bandwidth requirement in present scenario. So So this is the reasons what I have to told you. The maximum hop or station distance is limited to 1500 kilometer only. If you are opting ground wave or sky wave, so apart from 1500 kilometer, you can't transmit your signals. But as we have to seen in our earlier slides, that these limitations can be removed by the satellites, and one single satellite can be cover the 1/3 part of our Earth. So this is the large coverage area which we can achieve by using the satellite. So this is the reason. Okay, so this is the main reason for communication for longer distances, and for enhancing your bandwidth, we have to switch to the satellite communication. So again, we have to see how you can locate your satellite at a certain height above the Earth. So that is basically when you install your satellite up to the 36,000 kilometers. So that is basically you have to install your satellite. Okay, so what is the basic requirement? You have to require two Earth station, that is the based on your Earth, and one satellite, that is the based on your space. Now we will see what are the three laws of Kepler's law. So basically, when you have to install your satellite, so there is a very important role of Kepler's, and he have give the three laws for understanding the basic concept of our satellite, ki what is the speed of satellite and how satellite are work in with respect to Earth. So there is a basically, if you want to actually select the position of our satellite and we want to assume where is the Earth and where is the satellite, so Kepler's law is very important. So we will also see in Kepler's first law state that every planet, what type of planets are revolving around the sun or around the Earth, that shape of orbit is generally elliptical shape, and sun is one of the focus. So if you are assuming the sun, if with respect to Earth, if we are talking about the with respect to Earth, so if any satellite is moving around the Earth, so what will happen? The movement or path of that satellite will be the elliptical shape, and Earth will be at the one focus of your elliptical orbit. So as in your mathematics subject, you have seen that if we are talking about the elliptical shape, so there are two focus points, F1 and F2. So same thing is here exists. If you are assuming the path of our satellite, and if path is the elliptical shape, so there is again a two focus point, and in one focus point there is our Earth. So you can assume the place, yes, where is the Earth and where is your satellite is moving around the Earth. So this is the Kepler's first law. So you can also see in pics, so you can assume here ki this is the satellite, it is revolving around the Earth, and Earth is a one focus point. So you can see this is the two focus point of our elliptical shape, and there is a semi major axis and semi minor axis, as we have to study in our mathematics. So this is the base part of it. So that is the Earth, and it is the satellite which is revolving around the Earth. Now what about the second law? What the second law statement? According to Kepler, second law state that for equal interval of time, area covered by the satellite is equal with respect to the center of Earth. So again, we will see in this pic, it is better for understanding what will happen here. So that is, it is the center of Earth, and it is the basically the area covered by the satellite. So this area is S1, and this area is A2, and this is the A1 and A2, and this is the satellite. So now what will happen? Equal time period. If this time period is equal, so equal time period, the area swept by the satellite will be equal, means A1 is equal to A2. So this will be always both are equal time. So in equal time period, the area covered by the satellite will be the equal. So how you can calculate that particular area? That particular area is related to the center of our Earth. So this is our Kepler's second law. What about the third law? So third law states that square of the periodic time of orbit is proportional to the cube of mean distance between two bodies. So that is between the whatever the time period of the t square, that is equal to a cube. Okay, so that is a cube. So a is the half of the semi major axis of our elliptical orbit. So that is e is equal to, that is the relation between the ellipticity and the semi major axis, semi minor axis area. So this is the three rules of our Kepler's law. for representing the position of a satellite with respect to Earth. Now we will switch to the how a satellite works. So now it is a very important point is how satellite are works. We have to see in the general position of our satellite. So basically satellite stay in a orbit. So it's okay, it is stay in a orbit because gravitational pull of Earth is balanced by the centripetal force of the revolving satellite. So both are balanced. So without any problem, our satellite will be the stay in a orbit. So it will stay orbit. So that both forces are balanced in our satellite. Now we will again switch to the some popular frequency ranges. So in which frequency ranges we are working on our satellite. So C band, that is a 4 gigahertz is the downlink frequency and 6 gigahertz is the uplink frequency. As we have seen our previous slides that there are two different frequencies in which our satellite are working. So when we are working on C band, so frequency ranges is 4 gigahertz say 6 gigahertz. Now we switch to the KU band. So our frequency bands will be 12 gigahertz to 14 gigahertz. Now again we are switching to the KA band. So that is the 20 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. So why we are switching to the different frequencies? Because there is heavy traffic. If you are only using the 4 gigahertz and 6 gigahertz and we have the more than 2000 satellites, only communication satellites. So there is so many traffic. So for reduce that traffic, we are switching to the different frequencies. So initially we are working at the low frequency, then we are again moving to the higher frequency, then we are again moving to the higher frequency. But there is a disadvantage. If we are moving to the higher frequency, the attenuation loss will be higher in our that particular frequency. But due to overcrowded, we have to switch to the higher frequency. So there is no option for us. We have to compensate that particular attenuation at the particular system. Now we will also work to the satellite system. So microwave repeater. So what about the microwave repeater? So if you are talking about in digital system, what is the repeater? So repeater is just if signals are traveling a 1000 kilometer distances and then we will apply a repeater. Means what is the role of repeater? The repeater will filter the noise. So it is basically what will in repeater and new fresh signal will be generated. So in repeater section, we compare our signal with a threshold value. And if your signals are below that threshold value, that will be assumed as a zero. And above that will assume as a one and new fresh signal will be generated. So same work is done by our satellite. If we are working on the microwave repeater in the sky, so that is basically a consist of a different components. So that is repeater is a transmitter, receiver, amplifier, regenerator, filter, computer, multiplexer, demultiplexer, antenna, waveguide. So all these components in combined form is called as a microwave repeater. And these repeater is installed at the satellite. Satellite radio repeater is also called. So if you are talking about the repeater, so in satellite, we not called it as a repeater. We called it as a transponder. And this is usually a combination of transmitter and receiver. Because what type of signals you are transmitting from Earth, it will be received by the transponder. And after certain processing, reduce our frequency, it will be resent to the another Earth station. So that is the basically combination of a transmitter and the receiver part. And now what is the spacing between the satellite? So since we are working on the space, and we have to measure the angular separation. So basically the angular separation between two satellites should be 2 degree angles. And due to overcrowding, there is so many satellites are working. So we have to switch to the different frequencies. Generally, if you are talking about the applications of communication satellites that is used. So that is the television, telephone, radio, internet, and military applications are working in this part. So this is a basic what type of transponder, that is a receiver part. 6 gigahertz signals are received by it. There is low noise amplifier, amplification will be done. There is a mixer. We have in mixer, we have to mixing the local oscillator frequency and reduce 6 gigahertz frequencies converted into the 4 gigahertz signals. And after power amplification, it will be sent to the return back to the Earth. So this is a basically working of a satellite transponder. Now this is the same thing, but we have to show there is a body moves around. So same thing is here, again repeater circuit. So that is a transponder that is work as a, so there is nothing. There is a very basic block diagram, upcoming signal, there is a certain range, 6 gigahertz signals converted by mixer, 4 gigahertz signal. There is again a processing. We have to done the amplification. So we have used the EWT amplifier because BJT amplifier is not working at microwave frequency. So what will happen? You have to work out in the microwave amplifier. So traveling wave tube is a basically microwave amplifier, input multiplexer. So due to high frequency range signals, our amplifier will be also the modified form, and that is the output multiplexer, and we have again written back our signal. So this is a very general block diagram. Now what is the basically uplink frequency and downlink frequency? So why this concept is used, why transponder is called as a downlink frequency, and why is we will call it as a uplink? So there is a reason ki why we are not using the downlink frequency for transmission and we are using the uplink frequency. So there is a certain criteria ki when we are in earth, we have sufficient resources for generating or our signals or increasing the power of signals. But when we are on the satellite, there is no resources for enhancing the power because our satellite working is totally based on solar panels. Okay. And for working on solar panel, you have to take that solar panel from Earth. When once we have launched our satellite, so many solar panels are included in our satellites and they will be open according to time to time. So now what will happen here? So these solar panels are work out. So that is also a reason if your weight of your satellite is very high, costing of your launching of satellite will be very costly, will be. So you have to keep in mind ki a sufficient amount of solar panel is included in your satellite. So what will happen? There is easy to reduce the power of signals. So if you are working on the lower frequency in the satellite, it is easy to transmit our signals again to the Earth. So for upcoming, we are for transmitting, we are using the high frequency, and for retransmission from satellite, we are using the downlink frequency. So that is the basic reason. Now again, we will see here the transmitter receive signal satellite in a orbit around the Earth. So all things what we have to cover, I have to told you. Footprint. What is a footprint? Is the area which receives a signal of useful strength from the satellite. So there is basic. So satellite receive and retransmit signal back to the Earth, and these signals are received by the Earth station. So what is the coverage area of satellite? So what is the jo second Earth station hai? So what about the coverage area of satellite? So that coverage area is called as a footprint. Is the that area which receives a signal of useful strength, not the poor strength signals. So we will switch to the types of satellite. So it is a very also important point ki you have to discussion about the satellites. Yes, our satellite. So normal conditions when we are discussing about the satellite, so we are talking about the geostationary satellite. Okay, so now, but apart from geostationary satellite, there is again a requirement of our Earth changes. So our orbits are also changes in different height. So according to height, we are classified our orbit. So first of all, geo, as we know, that is a 36,000 kilometer from the Earth surface. But what about the MEO, medium Earth orbit? What about the LEO, lower Earth orbit? So these are, you can see here, from Earth surface, height of this LEO, lower Earth orbit, is means this orbit is very near to the Earth. After then we will see the medium Earth orbit. It is a slightly greater than the height of MEO, is larger than the LEO. And what about the red circle? That is the GEO, that is the 36,000 kilometer from the Earth. But benefit of GEO is, what will the benefit of GEO? What type of satellites are installed in GEO? Since due to same revolution period of both Earth and satellite, this satellite will be assumed as a stationary, means in which particular point or fixed point you are seeing from the Earth, you can see that your satellite is the, with respect to satellite, moment of Earth and moment of satellite is the same. So that is a, with respect to Earth, it is the stationary. So it is called as a geostationary satellite. And this will happens only at the height of 36,000 kilometer. But if you are installing your satellites in a lower Earth orbit, so now what will happens? Your Earth wave, if you are transmitting your signal from a Earth, so at when you have to
point out your satellite, but due to relative motion, between difference between relative motion of Earth and the orbit period, you have to take the so many satellite, because once you will start transmission, so at that particular time one satellite will be in front of that particular position, but after some time there will be another satellite will be comes. So that is called as a propagation delay, and we have to calculate all these things. But since height is very less, so we will discuss in our next slides, what is the height of our LEO. So height of our lower Earth orbit, that is basically circular orbit, and it is basically 160 to 2000 kilometer above the Earth surface. So now what will happen, there is a very height is very less, so period, so what is the period? 90 minutes. Okay, only 90 minutes time is consumed for revolving the Earth. So what will happen, you have to require so many satellites in LEO. Okay, only one satellite will not cover all times your particular fixed point. So this is the reason. But what is the benefit of your LEO? Because low altitude, these satellites are only visible within a radius of roughly 1000 kilometer from the sub-satellite point. So there are so many. So what will happen? There is a losses. If you are sending your signals to 36,000 kilometer, so what type of atmospheric degradation faced by that particular signal, that will not be included in LEO. So quality of signals will be good, but number of satellites you have to require large. So this is the reason. So basically, if you are talking about the LEO, lower Earth orbit, so it is basically used for mobile communications. Okay, so instead of using the geostationary satellite, due to proximity to the ground, don't require a high signal strength. Means you if you want to transmit your signal for GEO, you have to transmit very high strength signal, because you know this signal have to cover the distance of 36,000 kilometer. But if you are sending your signal to LEO, that so you know if you want to increase the strength of your signals, so that is you have to pay the power. So there is also a cost is included in that particular signals. So that is the reason when we are working on the LEO satellites, that is a less expensive. So if height is come less, so launching cost is also less of LEO. So you can launch so many satellites in LEO section. So there is a trade-off. If you are reducing the cost for launching, cost is reduces, but number of satellites is increases. So you there is a something trade-off between the number of satellites and launching cost. Now we will switch to the MEO. So that is basically MEO, height of MEO is 2000 to 36 kilometer range. Okay, so MEO satellites are basically similar to LEO satellites in functionality. There is nothing. MEO satellites are visible from much longer periods than LEO. So that is a basically mid between the GEO and LEO, and larger coverage area than LEO. So that is the thing. As you are increases, as your height is increases, satellite is launches very high. Height of satellite is high, so coverage area will be increases. So this is the reason. When you install your satellite to the geostationary orbit, 1/3 part of Earth can be covered by that particular satellite. So this is the reason. If your height is less, so your coverage area will be reduces. So in MEO, the coverage area will be higher than LEO, but lower than the GEO. So that is a basic reason. So visibility and wider footprints is that what is the coverage area. Received signal will be covered. So that is the same what I have to told you. MEO satellite distance gives it a longer time delay and weaker signal than a LEO. Same thing is, as you go higher and higher side, your strength of signals will be reduces and time delay will be increases. So this is the disadvantage which is not in our LEO. So there is some disadvantage and some advantage of particular layers. Like LEO, these satellites don't maintain a stationary distance from the Earth. So this is the, and basically in contrast to the geostationary orbit where satellites are 36,000. So this is the same thing what we have to told you here, what is the role of GEO and what is the role of that one. Now what is the GEO? So GEO is the same. This is because it revolves around the Earth same speed. So it is just like appears motionless or stationary. in the fixed position in the sky. And the distance is between 36,000 kilometer. And generally, we are using communication satellite for our GEO. In communication purpose, we are using GEO for our communication purpose. Now, we will see the applications of where radio broadcasting, voice communications, via TV broadcasting, direct to home services, DTH, internet applications, okay, such as providing internet connections for data transfer. So many applications, GPS, you know about the GPS system, our GPS system is also in our mobile. So that is play, basically what about the GPS? So GPS is work out on the MEO. Okay, so you have to know the internet applications, such we have to, there are so many applications. So in the that application, GPS is also a very important application, and that GPS is work on the medium earth orbit. And for taking the accuracies, because what is the global positioning system? You have to detect the accurate position of particular what type of things in installed on GPS, either it may be car, either it may be something. So you, if you have to find out the accurate position of that particular object, we can say it object. So now what will happens here? You have to take the 4 satellite at a time for actual detection of a accuracy. With accuracy, 4 satellites can detect the right position of that particular object. Because we have to know in MEO, there is no fixed stationary path, but quality of signals is very good. So at least 4 satellites are required for working of our GPS system. Military applications, remote sensing applications. So there are so many applications of our satellite communication. With using the satellite communication, we can use, today we have to see in direct to home service, every customer have its own disc shape antenna, which we have to install in our houses. You can know that. So that is what is a disc antenna? So that disc antenna is parabolic antenna, and it can directly receive the signal from the satellite. So there is no mediator, there is no any wire is connected through there. By that disc antenna, through your screen or TV set, you have to draw a particular line. That is a line connections. But by your antenna to satellite, there is no any wired connection. There is only a wireless connection. In old days, we have to take our disc. So what about the different channels we have to opt by using the? So if you are changing your DTH is a direct to home service. If you are opting any type of, if you want to buy the different channels, so your antenna should be also changed. So why they are changing? Because every stations or every TV stations are working on the different frequency. So according to that, you have to purchase the different types of disc antenna. So that is a basic slight variations here is. So now we will again switch to the applications. So advantage is, it's okay. What is the advantage of satellite? We have to many times discuss. A coverage area is very high. It is a very, each and every corner of Earth can be covered. So means that particular place where you can't reach, so your satellite can be reached, and it will take the pics from that particular places. So it is very easy to take the or reach out the that particular area where you can't physically present. Transmission cost is independent of coverage area, so it's also depend. It is not depend on the coverage area, and more bandwidth and broadcasting possibilities is possible only with the help of our satellite communication. So this is the advantage. There is also some slightly disadvantage because launching cost is very high. So it will be very high costing of launching a satellite. So it is not possible to person. It is basically if you want to launch a satellite, it is a very government agencies will be capable to launching the such high costing. There is also some private sectors, but costing is very, very costly. So what will happen? So how these costs can be recovered by the government or other private sector? So basically, when the satellite is launched, we have to require the large amount of bandwidth or spectrum, and these spectrum is now sell to the different distributors of our broadcasting system. So that is the basically they can cover our costing of launching cost by using that. particularly spectrum. So propagation delay of satellite system is more, so that is, there is propagation delay is also included. If you are working on the terrestrial system, there is no propagation delay, but if you are working on the satellite, since it is a very high height of that particular launches, so the propagation delay is also included. It is also difficult to repairing if there is anything is destroyed, so it is not possible to repair it. So we can generally add some the that is called as a that is a reliability of, it is also important because you have to insert the reliable component. So after very tough testing, we can make a satellite. Its components are so high quality that it cannot be easily destroyed. So that is also a reliable factors. That is also we have to maintain. If you have to working, suppose we are working on the TWT amplifier, so we have to insert 3, 4, 5 TWT NTR. If one is failed, so another one is quickly connected with that particular. If other is failed, so there are so many series and parallel combinations. We have to provide the redundancy component. So the actual name is in satellite language, that is the redundancy of. Redundancy means you have to provide some extra component because it is not possible to repair the particular satellite. Okay, so since it is not possible to repair or it is very tough to repair, so it, we have to provide the redundancy of so many components. Free losses is, since we are working on the free space, so no doubt loss is more than the wired connections. And there is congestion of frequency, so we are also switching to the so many types of frequency, so this is also the reason. Now we will switch the, this is the reason, this is the satellite. So what type of, there is multiple areas are covered by our, either it may be DTH, either it may be ship terminal, either we are working on the any fixed terminals or aircraft terminal. Everything is covered by a satellite. So this is the basic pics in which we can see that coverage area is very large in our satellite. DBS, you can know, direct broadcast satellite, as it is basically satellite signals on a TV. So that is, we are opting the different channels, and that is basically direct broadcast from satellite. So that is the role, and signals are digital signals. So that is encryption, or that is also possible. So security feature is also, we can also compress the signals, digital encrypted. So that is the most of the features are also included. So quality of signals will also enhanced by using the satellite also. This is the basic again diagram, DTH, direct to home service, signals will be. So sometimes there is a program is prepared, sent to the satellite, it will again send to the another station, DBS, distributor system, and it will again to the satellite, and that satellite will be direct transmitted to your house. So that is a dish antenna that is installed, that is the receiver part, which will be connected through the wire, as I have told you. So this is the DTH working, and it is possible by help of a satellite. That is same thing what I want to show you. DTH provider, Tata Sky, Big TV, Sun Direct Video, Dish TV, Airtel. So these are the various DTH providers in India. What about the applications? So other applications are navigation, communication, weather, earth observation. So just we can see some pics. Suppose we are working on the mobile satellite technology. So what will happen? Okay, we again want to mobility in our devices. If you are traveling in a aeroplane, so what will happen here? We have to again require a satellite, because without satellite, your cellular concept, GSM technology will not cover that. So some area is covered by satellite, and after then we have to include it with our cellular concept of mobile communication. So the cellular concept of mobile communication we have seen in our previous mobile communications videos. So that will be covered, how our mobile communication is possible. So satellite is also a part of our mobile communication, because without satellite, our coverage area will not be increases by the mobile communication system. And for these mobile communication system, generally we are opting the LEO, lower earth orbit. This is a weather. If you are talking about the weather, so variety of observations and analysis can be done. Earth observation, that the particular area where you can't reach, so that particular satellite can be reached out, and it will take the pics from that area. So it is also comfortable for us. forestry, if we are talking about the forestry, the forest mapping, management, fire damage monitoring, change detection, health, forest health analysis, all these controlling of forest. So it is not possible for a person to reach every particular area and see the particular managing of our forest area. So only this will possible with the help of our satellite. Telemedicine, it is also very important. Telemedicine is one of the unique application of space technology for social benefits. So ISRO telemedicine program started in 2001 and had been connected with the remote and rural medical college hospitals. So by using the satellite, we can easily control the medical health facilities also, mobile units through the Indian satellites to the major hospitals and cities. So presently, telemedicine network of ISRO has 384 hospitals with the 60 specialty hospital connected to the remote areas where they are working. Okay, so there are the mobile units. In a duration of flood, as we have seen in Bihar, there are many floods. So at that time, these mobile vans, these are the medical facility. Okay, on the mobility medicines are also with help of the satellite, because they are work through the satellite also. So all things is only possible. Defense, if you are talking about the defense and security, so it is also very important applications. Generation of maps, target monitoring, detection, everything is possible with help of satellite. So it is a very important. Again, we will compare with optical fiber. We have to see large bandwidth, high speed, mobility, reliability. So that is a different factor. So both are very important. Either we are talking about the optical, either we are talking about the satellite. But when we switch to the mobility, satellite is a great role in our communication system, because optical fiber is provide. So since we are moving to the 5G, optical fiber is important. But since we are also moving to the mobility, so satellite communication is also a major role on this one. So that is a simple, some objective questions on the our satellite communications. What about the, as the height of satellite orbit increases, so what about the speed of satellite? We can also transponder, what is the role of transponder? We can also see in our lectures, satellite that is used as a relay. So how we can use the satellite, which one is used as a relay? So you have to know the very small questions. Transmitter receiver combination is what we have called it. VHF, UHF, microwave signals, how they can transmit. What is the reason for shifting C band to Ku band? I have also told you overcrowding, that is a basic. So there are so many things and how we can transmit. So you can easily solve this question. So at last we will see that without satellite, there is nothing impossible in present technology, in present communication era. If we are moving towards the mobility, so it is a very important if we have to use the satellite. So everywhere we are using the satellite. So at present scenario, if we are seeing that if it is possible, half of the part will be covered by the satellite and remaining some part will be covered by the optical fiber. So there is a different combinations ki how much part, if you are included in our city area, so that will be interconnected with the optical fiber. And if you are moving to the rural areas, large areas, if we want to increase the coverage area, because with optical fiber, such amount of coverage area will not be achieved. So we have to move to the satellite system. So both are very important in our communication system. So that's all. Thank you.